Hey, y'all. Welcome back to Release Radar. I'm Chris Biscardi, and today I'm super excited to be talking about the new AWS SDK for Rust. AWS provides official SDKs for a number of different languages. These SDKs make it easier to work with the AWS services in the way that you would usually expect from a library built in that particular language. For example, in JavaScript, you get a separate package for each service. Concretely, the APIs offered by these SDKs allow you to perform actions such as querying a DynamoDB database or creating a VPC endpoint. Not every language is officially supported, though. That would be a lot of languages. So if you're using a newer language, or just one that Amazon hasn't prioritized, you're stuck having to maintain your own bindings. Now, due to how massive AWS's service offering is, maintaining a community-supported SDK is a correspondingly massive amount of work. That doesn't mean people don't do it, though. Rusoto, for example, is the major attempt at doing this in the Rust ecosystem, and it has been active since 2015. Given how big of a project this is, and as AWS launches more and more services, and the project gets bigger every year, it's not surprising that, unfortunately, the pure amount of work seems to have caught up with the Rusoto maintainers earlier this year, and the project was put into maintenance mode. One of the maintainers, Ileana, has been working on the new official SDK and wrote the announcement blog post, which leaves us with the future being AWS's official Rust SDK. Again, keeping in mind how much work it is to maintain an SDK like this, it's important to note that the primary design goal for the new SDK is to enable customer usage of new AWS service APIs when they launch. To do this sustainably, the process can't be manual. It must be automated. AWS's newer SDKs use code generation heavily based on a project called Smithy. Smithy lets you define protocol-agnostic services and SDKs and has been used internally at Amazon for over 10 years. Smithy RS contains the Rust runtime and code generation from AWS specs to a usable Rust SDK. The SDK generator is written in Kotlin itself, but if you search the repo, you can find large model descriptions for everything you can do with a particular service in large JSON files. With AWS's extremely large number of services comes all sorts of different communications protocols. For example, the Rust AWS SDK won't get support for the S3 service until support for the REST XML protocol is also included. What is included at the moment is 7 services: DynamoDB, API Gateway, Kinesis, Key Management Service, Secrets Manager, Poly, and Quantum Ledger Database. The alpha release isn't meant to be production ready, so use it at your own risk in production when you ship this Friday. And being an alpha, it's not on crates.io yet, so how do you use it today if you want to? Well, first off, you need Tokyo. Async standard or other runtimes aren't gonna work here. Then you can grab the crate you're looking for, as all services are their own crates, via the Git URL. The AWS SDK Rust project is a cargo workspace, and cargo supports installing packages from remote workspaces on GitHub. So we can use the URL and a branch tag to select the package and get to work. After that, you can drop in your AWS credentials into the environment, like you might be doing for any other SDK, and we're off to the races. Not every package might be what you expect yet. For example, the DynamoDB support is still only a low-level client. As you can see here, we're using direct attribute values and calling raw APIs like putItem. This means the DynamoDB implementation that is currently in the SDK is not a replacement for something like Dynamite, which you can see on the left here, or one of the higher level document APIs from another language's SDK. It is, however, in the GitHub issues, and I saw it mentioned in the blog post. So if these higher level DynamoDB clients are important to you, get involved on GitHub and voice your support. The roadmap is public, and it seems like they'll listen to user involvement. All that said, I'm pretty excited to see an official SDK for AWS from AWS. And this seems to indicate a nice future for AWS's involvement in Rust, which they've voiced intent for pretty vocally. Are you using Rust on AWS today, or do you want to? I know that I myself am deploying Rust Lambda functions today, so I'm super excited about using this in them in the future.